Hi, my name is Josh Evilsizor, and I'm going to show you an easy way to update your resume or your LinkedIn profile using AI. If updating your resume feels like translating your work accomplishments into a foreign language, you're watching the right video. Today we're going to answer the question, if updating your resume was easy, what would that look like? Today I'm going to give you the tools to translate your work experience into compelling corporate poetry in seconds. How? Well, I'm going to show you two prompts, I'm going to do some explaining, and I'm going to hand you the templates that I've created so you can let AI do the heavy lifting. Ready? All right. So here is my prompt library as a reminder for you to create your own prompt library. We're going to use these two prompts, and they are in this Google Drive folder, which I have linked in the description down below. Feel free to go ahead and open them up and copy, paste, or play along. Just don't forget to copy the document and save it to your prompt library. All right, here we are with the prompt. Big picture here. So we're going to have to provide the model some background, and that's going to take a little bit of time. But once we've built this, the idea here is build once, benefit forever. So assuming we're at a job for at least more than 4 weeks, which you'll understand what I'm talking about in a minute, this will serve us into the future. So yeah, we're going to spend a few seconds to save a bunch of time in the future. So prompt. As you know from watching previous videos, we're going to include PAO, which is persona, audience, and output. I put those letters in red in here so you can see where they're at. You don't need to have this in your prompt. Now I'll start talking about this particular scenario and why you see the information that you do. So I did work at this job for 4 weeks, and I created this prompt specifically to help me update my resume because it's tough to do when you only work somewhere for 4 weeks. In any event, here's the persona and the information that I gave it. So assume the persona of a senior production manager named Josh Evilsizor, working for a startup that builds prefab apartments, which is Connect Housing Blocks. And then I gave it the abbreviation or the acronym or initialism right here. So I can just continue using CHB throughout. Josh Evilsizor worked at CHB for 4 weeks and plans on, I'm going to pause here. So audience and output, all I really provide is the output, which is updating his LinkedIn profile. But when you provide the output here as such, when you provide an output here, it can imply the audience. So anybody that's on LinkedIn reviewing my profile is also the audience. So output, audience, kind of the same thing. As creatively as possible to highlight the good he did for the very short time he worked there. To assist, review the references below. CHB background, Josh's role at CHB, and Josh's accomplishments at CHB. And those are all going to be in the references. So this is the prompt, which is kind of like the Wavetops overview for the model so it understands what it's about to walk into and or do for us. So prompt complete. Here's the references. And this is where you're going to start to go, well, Josh, you're doing more work here than it would be to just create the bullet points. And I would submit this part was actually not hard at all. Background right here comes right off CHB's website. And so I just copied some of their compelling copy. And providing this to the model is going to give it tons of context and background to help smoosh this information into the accomplishments that I provide to it and give me some very powerful resume or LinkedIn bullets. And again, the more context we can provide, the better the model is going to do. You don't need to include this here. I put it here to highlight what we're doing is providing additional context. All right, the second piece here, Josh's role at CHB. So I just highlighted all the things that I was in charge of so it understood the breadth of my responsibilities because, of course, that can get folded into the resume bullets as well. So as a senior production manager, I ran the finishing section that completed the build of each modular unit or module. And I used words here that I'm going to use later on so it understands, of course, what those words mean or gives it more context. I managed the following 6 subcontractors. I listed those there. I managed a crew of 18 associates. I highlighted what I did for them. And then I was responsible for ordering all supplies, blah, 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 blah. So all of my roles and responsibility, or my role and responsibilities there at CHB. All right. So this stuff came right off the website right here. This came just out of my head pretty easily. You can see it's not written in any fancy format. It's literally just free-flowing. As I thought of it, I typed it. Bullet point format's the easiest way to go. You don't even have to connect sentences. All right, the final piece here, which is what we're trying to do, is take my accomplishments at CHB and turn these into compelling corporate poetry. We're developing that buzzword ballet, right? It's gonna fit right into the resume and look really nice. So all I did here was basically stream of consciousness, just listed all the things that I did while I was there. Develop a comprehensive checklist, and then I highlighted, whereas previously there was no viable checklist in use, which is helpful, right? I created out of thin air. And in the first 2 weeks, they did the following, and then I listed the things that checklist did. What's the next bullet point here? Created an in-production parking plan, again, that didn't previously exist. They identified the location of each module within the factory, saving hundreds of man hours looking for a module on the 630,000 square foot warehouse plant floor. And you're looking at that misspelled word going, what's going on there, Josh? I wanted to highlight that when I created this, I didn't even bother to fix the misspelled words. The goal here is just to get all of this out of my head as quickly as I could into this section right here of accomplishments, and then give the model the prompt and let it do its magic. Another very quick way of getting stuff out of my head and into the document is through voice typing. And if you watch any of my videos before, you've probably seen me do this. And so you can see here, if I put my cursor right here and then hit enter, and then I move the bullet point in, I can easily type and add bullets much faster than I could type with my fingers. Typing with my voice is just so much quicker. And check out this other neat thing that I did. So as you can see, voice typing gets that stuff out of our head, not through our fingertips, but out of our mouth onto the page even quicker. Now, I'm gonna go ahead and remove this because the model would be confused when we go to create or when we go to provide this prompt. And there we go. So just don't forget voice typing. All right. Let me go ahead and cinch this up. So we've got prompt, references. Now here's our rules. Limit each bullet to 190 characters. Josh, why characters? Why 190 and why not words? Whenever I've tried to limit it to word count before, they don't do so well. They do really well with characters. Well, Josh, how do I figure out how many characters I want? Well, let's say this sentence right here was perfect. Let's say this is the right character length for you. Control, Shift, C in Google Docs and highlight characters excluding spaces, that's what you want. So if this was the perfect length, you can see here it's 54 characters, and that's what you could roll with. I'm asking for 190 characters. And then the last rule here, as you saw, be creative and make each bullet point as impressive as possible, because I only worked there for 4 weeks and I need a lot of help. All right, got the rules down, and then here's the instructions. Your job is to follow and complete the steps listed below. Review the prompt. Review the references. Develop 3 bullet points summarizing the key activities Josh completed while working at CHB in the most favorable light possible. Again, I worked there for 4 weeks. I need your help. Finally, chain of thought here. We're telling it step by step what to do. Just increases our chances for success. I'll link a video in the description down below on how to develop prompts if you haven't seen those before. And then think step by step. Those steps right there, and ask any questions before starting. And because Claude writes the best, we are going to go ahead and give this prompt to Claude. But of course, there are a million different ways that we could execute this prompt. We could turn this into a custom GPT so that it's an enduring product that we could use. We could create a gem in Gemini. So custom GPT and ChatGPT, we could create a gem in Gemini. We could create a folder in ChatGPT, drop this document in there and some other stuff, and we could chat with it and go from there. But I'm just going to use plain old Claude because Claude writes the best. I'm going to upload the document that we just downloaded, which is our CHB prompt. It's uploaded, I hit the send button. I don't even need to type anything. And Claude is gonna give us some great stuff. Um, how did it, let's see here, revolutionized production tracking by implementing comprehensive module completion systems spanning 30 plus unique steps across 35 concurrent builds, dramatically enhancing workflow efficiency. Thank you, Claude. If I didn't like this, it's free, right? Make it better. compress, expand, make it more punchy. Have the conversation till you get to where you need. But at the end of the day, it's the model's doing the heavy lifting for you, and you don't need to spend brain calories trying to update your resume when you can spend brain calories doing more important things. So there's a great example of, or there's the first example that I want to show you. Hopefully you thought it was great. All right, so next example I got for you is from my time here at Atlas, where I'm back after my four-week stint at a different job. And we did a AI rollout where we trained everyone at headquarters on AI. And I thought, well, that's something worth adding to my LinkedIn profile, my resume, so let me do that. So here is our prompt. And you can see here the format is different. And guess what? It worked. So is the format, does it matter? Not a whole lot, as long as you're providing persona, audience, output, context, and the other key components that we're going to go over here, but the format's not critical is what I'm trying to say. So again, persona, assume the persona of Josh Evilsizer, who's preparing to update his resume with his most recent accomplishments. So that's persona, audience, and output. Again, I don't really include the audience, but the output is resume bullets. So the audience is assumed people that would be reviewing those resume bullets. So a potential employer, somebody in the professional business sphere. All right. Rolling out the use of, so this is the output, the bullets highlighting my accomplishments, rolling out the use of artificial intelligence to all of our folks at Atlas. And then there's more blah-bitty blah about my background right here, which is not critical for us to go over during this video. So there is the prompt, persona, audience, output. References, this is where, again, providing more context is key. Again, just want to highlight, once we've got this background here, and you can see in this portion, I didn't include a large, I didn't do like I did with CHB, because the background's not critical. We're going to focus more on the workshop rolling out, the AI workshop that I did rolling out AI. So a ton of background about Atlas is not critical. What's most important here is all the background on the AI workshop, because I want it to take all the goodness that I did, and I want it to compress and pull out the very best. More emphasis here, though, again, on just when you put the stuff in here, it doesn't have to be clean. Bullet points are the easiest. Make it messy. And what I haven't highlighted already, you might say, Josh, couldn't I just do this multimodally with ChatGPT voice mode on my phone? Can I just tell it, hey, update my resume, and here's the things that I did, and give it and have it give me bullets? You absolutely could do that. And if you're really good at saying a lot of stuff and remembering it the next time, or you just don't want to have a tool that you can use later, that might be the better way to go. But my goal here is to create a prompt that I can use later. Second, to write is to think twice. And so when you write all this stuff out and then you look at it and you read it, you might realize things that you left out and then add those in. So what did I include here? What did I do? I learned large language model AI chatbots by creating and publishing 35 YouTube videos teaching AI, some with over 25,000 views. Is this going to make its way to my resume? Probably not, because it doesn't really relate. But I wanted the model to fully understand the amount of research and learning I did to it wasn't in support of creating this workshop, but it definitely fed into my knowledge, fed into that workshop. So this background's important. The YouTube videos covered all facets of AI chatbot use, including, and a bunch of uses here, Josh used all this experience to develop a comprehensive interactive 2-hour artificial intelligence workshop. The reviews and feedback. So what I did here is I had two classes, and for each class, the AI 101 class, and then I had an AI writing class, I literally just took the survey results, which was a spreadsheet. When you fill out a Google form, it feeds a spreadsheet. And so I just took all of the feedback from the survey results and just pasted it into here. So although it looks like I wrote a lot, it's just a copy paste from the survey results. And the same thing here with the AI-assisted writing class survey results. Copy-pasted right out of the spreadsheet. And once again, just left in the misspelled words because it doesn't matter. The goal is to get it out of your head, onto the page, and not have to work real hard. We're trying to play life on easy mode here. All right, a key outcome of these classes were the following. So AI adoption across the company. All negative stigmas with using AI to accomplish work were removed. And then employees were given enterprise AI chatbot access. So there is all the dynamic information that I need to give the model so it can create some really compelling buzzword ballet for me. All that resume rhetoric or company corporate poetry that we're looking for. And then the rules are the same. Each bullet limited in 190 characters, and be creative and make each bullet point as impressive as possible. That is the goal. Think for me, please. All right, and then the instructions are also the same. So your job is to follow and complete the steps listed below, review the prompt, review the references, develop 3 bullet points summarizing Josh's accomplishments, deploying AI at Atlas in the most favorable light as possible. And then think step by step and ask any questions before starting. All right, so let's collapse all these. And then we could download the Word document, which I've already done. This time we're going to use Poe, but we're still going to use Claude. So I'm just going to invoke Claude here. And if you're not familiar with Poe, so you could pay for pro models for each individual model, like Claude, Gemini, ChatGPT, or you could spend $20 a month, which is the same on those other models individually, or $20 a month and use Poe to get access to all of them. And that's what I've chosen to do here. So you can see here I've invoked Claude, so it's going to pull up this model right here. And then I'm going to go ahead and, of course, give it the AI adoption prompt, hit enter, and let it do its magic. Just like before, hey, give me more. This is okay, so let's look at this for a second. First, I'll identify the key accomplishments. So the YouTube video is not really an accomplishment that I'm going to highlight, but background for it. Developed, delivered comprehensive workshops, achieves high adoption rates, implemented enterprise-wide AI solutions. Target audience is LinkedIn, which values quantifiable achievements and business impact. Again, persona, audience, and output. And when you give it the audience, or when you give it the output, the audience is implied. Key metrics to highlight. And then here are the 3 optimized 190 character bullet points for LinkedIn. Led enterprise-wide AI transformation at rapidly growing defense contractor, driving 66.7 frequent adoption rate through development of blah, blah, blah. Created viral AI education series. Probably wouldn't include that. Design delivered AI workshop achieving 88.9% perfect satisfaction scores. That one's good. So I like the last one. Keep it. Give me 2 more. Tell you what, I like the last one. Give me 20 more bullets. It's free. And just find the ones that you like. You can do this all day long, of course. All right. I think you get it. That is it. My goal is always to help regular people like you and me play life on easy mode. If I did that here today, please let me know. Don't forget all the link goodness down below, and please like, subscribe, and share this video with others that might like it or could use it. As always, if you leave questions, I'll leave answers. Now, go and be productive.